Welcome to Chemistry Online Classes. The next topic is heterocyclic compounds. What are heterocyclic compounds? These are the cyclic organic compounds in which more carbon atom of the ring are replaced by the hetero atom. These we call it as heterocyclic compound. If you take any cyclic ring, one of the carbon atom in the ring structure is replaced by hetero atom. Other than carbon atom, we call it as hetero atom. So what are all hetero atoms? Hetero atoms may be nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur. These all we call it as hetero atoms. So one of the carbon is replaced by either nitrogen, phosphorus, oxygen. Those we call it as heterocyclic compounds. Let's take a simplest example. If you take a benzene, it is cyclic organic molecule and aromatic molecule. So here what I am doing, one of the carbon I am replacing and I am introducing nitrogen. So here what I have done, this carbon is replaced with a nitrogen, and this is called as heterocyclic compound. In the cyclic carbon skeleton, we have replaced one carbon with a nitrogen, and this we call it as heterocyclic molecule. Heterocyclic compound. And the name of this compound is pyridine. Next, we move on to classification of heterocyclic compounds. Heterocyclic compounds are classified based on the ring size. The first classification based on ring size and number of hetero atoms. Present in the ring skeleton. Let's take a first one. Generally, heterocyclic compounds, most important rings are 5-member and 6-member rings, and these rings are present in the natural products or most of the drugs which is having a 5 or 6-member heterocyclic, or some of the cases we can see fused heterocyclic compounds. So first one I am taking 5-membered heterocyclic compounds with one hetero atom. For example, the cyclic ring which is having a 5-member and number of hetero atom present in the ring skeleton is only 1. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is a 5-member heterocyclic compound. The number of hetero atom present is only nitrogen, 1, and this compound name is pyrrole. Let's take another example, 5-member with 1 hetero atom. It is thiophene. The third one is furan. All these cases, that cyclic ring is having 5 member with one hetero atom, and this classification is based on ring size and number of hetero atom. So here first case I have taken 5 member skeleton with one hetero atom. Let's take another examples with one or more hetero atom if it is present in the 5 member heterocyclic compounds. With more than 5 membered heterocyclic compound with more than one hetero atom. So in this case the cyclic ring structure is 5 membered but number of hetero atom present in the ring skeleton is 2 hetero atom. Now you can see here it is a 5 member heterocyclic compound, and how many hetero atoms are present? 2, oxygen and nitrogen. And this is an example for 5 member heterocyclic compound with more than one hetero atom, and the compound name is oxazole. Similarly, I'll take one more example. I take a 2 nitrogen. Here, 5 member ring with 2 hetero atom, and this compound name is imidazole. Let's take another example. Here I have changed the position of the nitrogen. Here 1-3 position, here 1-2 position. And here this is also 5 membered heterocyclic compound with 2 hetero atom, and the compound name is pyrazole. So in the 5 member heterocyclic compound, again we are classifying based on the number of hetero atoms present in the heterocyclic compounds. Similarly, let's take on the 6 member heterocyclic compound with one hetero atom or more than one hetero atom. 6 member ring heterocyclic compound having one hetero atom. So the ring size is 6 member ring. It should present one of the hetero atom in the ring skeleton. Those we call it as 6 member ring heterocyclic compound having one hetero atom. Here I am taking nitrogen. So this is an example for 6 member heterocyclic compound having one hetero atom. The compound name is pyridine. It is an aromatic compound. You can take a saturated compound also. It is also 6 member heterocyclic compound, and the compound name is piperidine. Pyridine is a unsaturated compound and piperidine is a saturated compound. Here let's take 6 member heterocyclic compound having more than one hetero atom, having more than one hetero atom. Let's take example 6 member heterocyclic compound having more than one hetero atom. Let's take 2 nitrogen here. This is an example for 6 member heterocyclic compound having more than one hetero atom. The compound name is pyrazine. If I change this position, here the relationship between nitrogen and nitrogen is 1-9-4 position. Let's take 1-9-3 position nitrogen. This is also 6 member heterocyclic compound having 2 hetero atom. and this is compound is very familiar. It is pyrimidine. Let's check the position of the nitrogen. 1-2 positions. And this compound name is pyridazine. So these are the example for 6-member heterocyclic compound having more than one hetero atom. So this classification is based on the ring size and number of hetero atoms which are present. Some cases we are going into the 3 hetero atoms also, that is anyway behind our scope. Along these two classification, we have third classification, that is fused heterocyclic compounds or condensed heterocyclic compounds. Fused or condensed heterocyclic compounds. So here heterocyclic ring is fused to the another carbocyclic ring or maybe another heterocyclic ring, that we call it as fused or condensed heterocyclic compound. For example, if I take a quinoline, this is the structure of the quinoline. Here this ring is heterocyclic ring and this is carbocyclic ring. Heterocyclic ring is fused with the carbocyclic ring and this we call it as fused or condensed heterocyclic rings. This is one example. I can give you one more examples also. Another one is indole, where pyrrole ring is fused with the benzene ring. This molecule is called as indole. If you take another example, benzene fused with furan, this is compound called as benzofuran. So these are example for fused or condensed heterocyclic compounds. So it is maybe carbocyclic or maybe another heterocyclic. So these are the general classification with respect to the ring size, first one, and number of hetero atom present. And the third one is depends upon the heterocyclic compound or fused heterocyclic compound. Next one also we can classify based on the aromatic character. Classification based on their aromatic or non-aromatic character. So here first one is non-aromatic heterocyclic compounds. Non-aromatic heterocyclic compounds. In this non-aromatic heterocyclic compound, the hetero atom is present in the non-aromatic skeleton. Those compounds we call it as non-aromatic heterocyclic compounds. Let's take a 3-member heterocyclic now. So it is a 3-member heterocyclic compound and one hetero atom is present in the cyclic structure. Whether it is aromatic? No, it is a non-aromatic molecule. The compound name is axyrene. These are the example for non-aromatic heterocyclic compound. Let's take another one. Instead of oxygen, I replace with nitrogen. And this is an azeridine. This is also an example for non-aromatic heterocyclic compound. I can increase the ring size also. This is the familiar example, tetrahydrofuran, which is an example for non-aromatic heterocyclic compounds. Let's take another one, aromatic heterocyclic compounds. That means hetero atom is present in the aromatic ring skeleton. Those we call it as aromatic heterocyclic compounds. Aromatic heterocyclic compounds. Example, furan. furan is a aromatic heterocyclic compound, thiophene, pyrrole. Pyridine. All these compounds are aromatic in nature, so these compounds we call it as aromatic heterocyclic compounds. So this is about the classification of heterocyclic compounds. Next class we will discuss about the aromaticity of these heterocyclic compounds.